Hey there, Molly Carmel here, fiercely devoted to your freedom. You know, I've given up a lot of things, and I remember when I broke up with snacking, I remember telling my dad, who had already watched me give up so many things, and if you could have seen my dad's face when I told him that I was breaking up with snacking, he looked at me and he says, "That's a very big deal. Are you sure you were going to be able to do that?" And you guys, that's like after I'd already broken up with alcohol, I'd broken up with sugar. I mean, the list had gone, cigarettes, I mean, the list had gone on and on and on. And breaking up with snacking can really like pull at the heartstrings the same way that breaking up with sugar can, because when we're doing those bites, licks, and tastes, the BLTs, and when we're just like, you know, eating like whenever we feel we can, like a little squirrel, like just, you know, at the desk and in your car and on the done and when you're feeding your kids and this and this and this. I mean, in a way, it's the same kind of slavery that we have to sugar, except that we're a slave to our hunger cues. And I would actually argue that we're a slave to these hunger cues that we've created, because they're not real, but we've reinforced them over and over and over again, that our mind, our stomach, our endocrine system, they just think they're gonna get what they want. They're sort of like a spoiled brat child. And so the reason why breaking up with snacking is so important is that getting your hunger cues regulated is where the real freedom lies. You know, the other thing I can remember about when I was like such a snacker, I can't even tell you. And I would have like, I would be like in session with people and have like little snacks next to me that I would eat during session. It occurred to me one day how incredibly inappropriate this was, or I would be in between sessions like stuffing my face with like low calorie popcorn, or back in the low fat days, like low fat crackers. It was such chaos. And I recognized like what a slave I had become to my hunger. But the other thing is, re-regulating your hunger cues is such a place of freedom, and being able to sit with hunger and not have to get so hangry, you know, hungry and angry, and not need to feel so nervous and not need to feel like, oh, I need to eat now. Oh, I mean, on the other side of it, it's a freedom that is so much like breaking up with sugar. And if you've broken up with sugar, you know what I mean. And if you haven't broken up with sugar, it's an amazing, amazing thing. And so, you know, turning the tables on your hunger and you being in control of it instead of it controlling you, it is just peaceful, right? And the other thing that it does is it takes the noise out of the situation. And then, you know, if you're someone who's into releasing weight, a lot of times, you know, the devil is in the details. And the thing is, with the snacking, it really fosters denial. Like, don't even know I am lying. You know, I've had clients that have shown me their food, they've written down their food, and they have forgotten complete meals. They've forgotten that they finished their children's French toast in the morning. They've forgotten that they like just went through the drive-thru really quickly and they had like a half of a hamburger with their friend. I mean, when you're not committed to eating at regular intervals, what we call meal regulation, or when you're committed to snacking, when it's an okay thing for you, it messes with those cues, but it also messes with you being able to release weight. It just messes with so many things. And for me, I think it really messed with my integrity, right? Because I was not in a trusting relationship with food. I was not in a trusting relationship with hunger. I would be like eating and then I would be full, but then I would want to eat more because it was lunch. It was just so loud and messy. And if you're nodding your head right now being like, oh, Molly, please stop telling my truth, the only thing I can say to you is the freedom on the other side is everything. I mean, getting free from being enslaved like we are to sugar and like we are to snacking, those things that are so hard to give up have the most freedom on the other end. I'm a living, walking example, and I have so many people that have broken up with snacking that would be like, yeah, it was really hard, but Oh my goodness. And you deserve full freedom, my friend. You deserve full freedom. And that's going to start with breaking up with snacking. So listen, what do you think? Too hard to do? Easy to do? Can I do it sometimes? I want to know what you're thinking. Leave a comment. I'd love to hear about it. And also, I'd love for you to be the first to know what's going on with me, because I'm obsessed with you. So why don't you subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, maybe like, maybe share, who knows? But no matter what, I am here rooting for you. We've got this.